The meaning of the phrase God is there in each particle of the universe is that there is a unanimous reality that exists inevitably and compulsorily in whatever there is. And that reality is of only two substances contrary to each other in nature. One is the soul and the other is the matter. The one who accesses this discriminative insight is on the path to becoming God or Paramatma. Taking the subject of discrimination between the self and the non-self, our teacher Acharya Kundakund describes further, the discriminative knowledge between the soul and the matter leads one to discard all alien dispositions, considering them entirely foreign to the nature of the self. Therefore, the person who starts considering not only his material possessions as alien, but also his emotions in the same way, stops accumulating karma and hence prepares the ground to step out of the ongoing cycle of cause and effect. After listening to this teaching, all of us ponder that it is easy to discriminate between physical objects and our transcendental reality. For example, all material objects indeed have separate identities from us. Even our relations like our mother, our children, etc. are other individuals. We can also have such kind of realization even in our youth that our body and soul are two different entities and we grow, we talk, we express and we do other activities until we have soul residing in our body. Because as soon as one dies, the growth, expression and other activities are halted. But how our emotions like anger, fear, despair and joy are separate from us? Isn't our soul the source of these two? According to the text we are studying, the answer to the above question is a no. To understand this, let us take an example. There is no doubt that one is a permanent resident of his home. And all his welcomed, invited and sometimes unwanted guests come, stay for a while, enjoy his hospitality, sometimes bother him, but eventually leave. In this example, the permanent resident is the common, unchanged constant who has been perpetually there in his abode. Now pause, sit back, take a deep breath and ponder. Do our emotions like anger, pride, lust and whatever stay with us forever? By forever, the teacher means perpetually, in an unchangeable degree or state. Surely, everyone's answer will be negative. We all will admit that emotions arrive in various degrees and influence us for a certain period, sometimes lesser and at the other more, but eventually leave us. We also know that there are people around us who are more emotionally intelligent and the same emotion that bothers us does not bother them. For example, when a housemaid breaks an expensive glass, one homemaker may get highly upset, whereas another may take it as a usual happening. I hope you are getting the gist of what the teacher is conveying here. To clarify, let us move to the following teaching of soul science, where the guru says, I am unique since I am of the nature of knowledge and perception. Here are the two attributes of the permanent resident, knowledge and perception, known as Gyan and Anubhuti in Hindi. The teacher says the soul, the permanent resident, knows everything about the guests, be they wanted, unwanted, welcomed or unwelcomed, and is aware of them, but it is not its guests. It has its own unique identity. Sometimes for the sake of practicality, the soul has to deal with these emotions, these guests, and at the other, it endures them because of its own shortcomings. But in no way it is the source of them. Let us take the same example of the housemaid breaking the glass again. We notice that the breaking of the glass acts as an instrumental cause to initiate the emotion of anger in the homemaker. But the real cause, the substantial cause, belongs to the homemaker only. I hope it all makes sense to you. And now, here are the five key takeaways from today's teachings. 1. All our emotions, be they good or bad, are our guests. They visit us for different time durations and in various degrees, but eventually they leave us. 2. As the permanent travelers of our individual journeys, we know and perceive these emotions, but we are not their real originators. 3. Different happenings in our surroundings act as instruments to provoke these emotions in us. 4. Through our life's experiences and teachings like these, we can be wise enough to deal with our emotions from a distance, considering them alien to us. 5. Through this discriminative knowledge, we accumulate lesser karmic baggage, which in turn sows the seeds of a lighter and spiritual future journey. And finally, it is the time for meditation derived from today's teachings. Take a few deep breaths. Relax every muscle and joint of your body. Close your eyes. Calm your mind and ponder. I am the divine light that illuminates the inner as well as the outer cosmos. I am the pure consciousness that knows the opposite nature of self and other than the self. Be they the material world or my emotions. My soul is the permanent resident beneath all the physical and psychical changes. Though I express myself through different emotions, I am beyond them. I am an ordinary soul on my individual and unique path to becoming the God soul. I am the all-knowing, all-perceiving consciousness. I choose to lighten my karmic baggage by gaining the right knowledge. You may now open your eyes. Take care and goodbye.